Thank you, Jay and Anirudh, for giving me an opportunity here. Dr. Anirudh has given first leg. Okay. Given a nice overview about the pachychoroid disease spectrum, I am going to talk on two conditions, pachychoroid pigment epitheliopathy and focal choroid excavation. Both of these, they don't have a treatment, but it is important to identify them because of long-term implications. So this the triad of pachychoroid spectrum, we have already understood from the previous talk. There is increased choroidal thickness, dilatation of outer choroidal vessels called pachyvessels, and attenuation of other layers of choriocapillaries. And this is a spectrum starting from pigment epitheliopathy to CSCR to PCN to PCV. This is a usual, some of them go through all these stages, some of them will not go. There are a lot of things to be known about pachychoroid clinical spectrum, but this is a usual spectrum of the diseases. So the PPE or pachychoroid pigment epitheliopathy has two, three typical characteristics. In fundus autofluorescence, there will be hyper and hypo autofluorescent area. In OCT, there will be some hyperplasia of the retinal pigment epithelium, and choroid is characteristically thick. So this was the initial presentation, publication of nearly 15 years back it was done. There is pachyvessel, and at that area, there is thinning of RP. So there is, the most important thing is there is no documented evidence of subretinal fluid presently or in past, like autofluorescence is not showing a tract or anything. There is no evidence of subretinal fluid. And this pachychoroid pigment epitheliopathy may represent a formifrostia of CSC because this is also in the same spectrum. ICG can reveal choroidal hyperpermeability. So this was another picture where there is an orangish red lesion, no SRF. And at the area of pachyvessel, you can see some RP atrophy. Drusen-like reflective deposits under the layer of RP may be seen. And small RP protuberances are there due to hyperplasia of RP with irregular RP. So these are the findings of PPE. ICG, as I already told, there is hyperpermeability of choroidal vessels. And this is the autofluorescence hypo-hyper mixture. This is an illustrative case where there was actually right eye has clinically pigment modeling in the macula, and there is fluid in the right eye, and left eye is dry, but you can see that protuberances, shallow PED, RP irregularities. So right eye was diagnosed as PCN based on multimodal imaging and was treated, but left eye had PPE. So same patient can have both in different eyes. Coming to the second topic given to me, that is focal choroidal excavation. This we have published an article last year in Indian Journal of Ophthalmology. I'm just giving a summary of that article. This is a concavity in the choroid of unknown etiology. We don't know whether it is congenital or acquired, because I will show you some cases where it can be congenital or acquired. And even though most of them believe that it is congenital, it can be seen in pachychoroid diseases and can develop later after CNVM. This is case one. The case one, you can see a classic choroidal neovascular membrane. And pointer is the point. Okay, mouse only. Yeah. So here, this is the focal choroidal excavation, which was present initially itself. This is before treatment, and this is after treatment, where subretinal fluid has gone. So this is a case where CNVM has developed at the site of focal choroidal excavation. Now coming to another case, this is another classic lacy pattern in early phase with the fuzzy margin in angiogram. Here also you can see this focal choroidal excavation here with subretinal fluid. This is before treatment, and after treatment the fluid has gone. The important thing is you can see some fluid like area at the bottom of this focal choroidal excavation. This is not SRF, this is called non-conforming focal choroidal excavation. So this should not be mistaken for fluid and treated unnecessarily. So this is a dry macula with a non-conforming type of focal choroidal excavation. This is another case where there is classic CNVM leaking in late phase with subretinal fluid. And in fact, after treatment, it became dry here. The FC is there, confirming type of FC is there. And later, it became non-conforming. So the transformation from non-conforming to confirming, conforming to non-conforming can happen in focal choroidal excavation. This should not be mistaken as a recurrence. This is another case where we had a choroidal osteoma, and that is nicely seen in this EDI with fluid, because there was a hemorrhage here and there was a choroidal neovascular membrane at the side. And after treatment, you can see at the edge of the choroidal osteoma, there is a focal choroidal excavation coming. So this is another case. So even though there are reports that it can be congenital, we are showing some cases where it is acquired. Initially, it was not present. The theory, we don't know why it happens. Some focal scarring resulting in bulging out of choroid, that is, or inflammation, we are not sure. But this has to be identified. This is an OCT finding. This has to be identified so that unnecessary treatment may not be given with for fluid. And follow-up is required in these cases. So FC is an OCT-based diagnosis associated with pachychoroid disease, and it can be congenital and acquired. The significance remains unknown, and monitoring is all that is required. Thank you.